Pop Boys Radio with your boy Tom Capone. Coming up later in the show, I'm going to talk to a friend of the show. Take him over to the Boost Mobile Lounge. That's right, the Ransford Boost Mobile Lounge. We're going to talk to him over there too as well, man. Antoine Walker in on Power 92, man. It's at Hot Boys Radio. There's Power 92. It's coming.
The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. The system broken, the school's closed, the prison's open.
All right, here we are, man. The Ransford Boost Mobile Lounge. Here with my brother, man, Antoine Walker. What's happening, man?
Man, not much, Tom.
Yeah, let's just jump right to it. The documentary, Gone in an Instant. Now, you had a 30 for 30 where they mentioned you a lot in the 30 for 30. And now you decided, what prompted this to do your own separate one?
Kind of just over the last couple of years, just reading some of the articles that was written about me and things that was said about certain things in my lifestyle that bothered me. And you can in the article, you can't really get what you want out. So I think I decided, you know, I got met with my friend in LA and I was like, man, I want to try to shoot a documentary. And we started the project about 2 years ago. And I wanted to be more shout from people that actually knew me and been around me and understand my struggle and actually enjoyed some of the finer things that we did in life. So it's kind of for family, friends, coaches, lawyers, people that have been a part of this process over the last 15, 20 years.
Okay, not giving anything away because we want people to definitely check out the documentary. Me kind of being on the outside of that whole time with you, the one thing that I want to ask you is, like, do you feel like that it happened so fast that you just kind of couldn't really get your whole arms around that whole situation?
Well, I think for me, and not for a lot of people, the biggest thing for me is that I wasn't here. And the way I lost bulk of my money was in the real estate market. So by not really being here and not knowing, having somebody else in control of it, it happened for me real fast. So when I got wind of it and finally got control of it, it was kind of too late. Mm-hmm. So I had to try to kind of get in and get lawyers in play and try to salvage what I can. Mm-hmm. And so it was a learning process for me as well. So it wasn't just something that I could actually just grasp and knew what I was getting in trouble of. So just being able to get some lawyers in place, and I lived in Miami for a long time. I wasn't in Chicago, so I stayed in Miami even when I retired. So that was a big thing too. So I had to come here and really get a grasp of it because most of the real estate was here in Chicago. So that was disappointing to me because I left my wealth in somebody else's hands. So that's something that I would always regret. But that was the main thing. So it was super fast to really answer your question. It happened fast, but I was able to grasp it and figure out the best situation for now.
Okay. And then another thing, like, you know, I've always said that, you know, outside of, you know, it's only a few Chicago celebrities and super athletes that we've had to reach the heights that you have. And you've always come home and you've always given back. You've always brought your lifestyle, your friends that probably would have never even came to Chicago if it wasn't for you. But then you hear people kind of turn on you, so to speak, when things take a turn and they want to crack a joke or people want to. God, how does that make you feel? You know what I mean?
That really didn't bother me. I come from a very poor background. My mother was a single parent of six, so I come from that type of background. The money aspect doesn't bother me. I just have two daughters that are of age, that read newspapers, that are on social media nowadays. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, you always want them to be okay. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You never want them, that their father, to be put in a negative light. So I'm more worried about them more so than me. It's just kind of fair weather. You learn. You live and learn. It's something that you will see in the documentary, that you can see friends that you had and you thought they were your friends and kind of, you know, went away when things got tough. But my thing is this, it's just money and obviously we have to live, we have a certain lifestyle we have to live and we pay for ourselves. But I enjoy it. I've been blessed 10 times, man. To be in the position I am today and to be sitting right here in this Boost Mobile Lounge talking to you about my trials and tribulations is the blessing. So that's how I get through it. Mm-hmm.
And well said. I mean, I always say, like, I've never, like, and coming up, you know, we kind of came up around that same time. You know, my radio career kind of started the same time as your NBA career. And you know, just to watch you and you see me out, and by no means was I as popular as I am now, or Shaq is now, but you always show love. You always show love, and that's something I just, you know, personally want to tell you thank you for. Now, this is another question I think maybe other people want to know, like me, like, okay, financial situation, you got all this stuff going on, but you have this talent, you have this knowledge, and I know, and just being with you personally, I know you got this personality, this incredible personality. Why haven't you tried to move into maybe commentating, where you're coaching, what's stopping you?
Really, I have tried a little bit, not as much as I would like to. Mm-hmm. I think the problem is, and this is another reason I film documentary, when you're from the outside, people on the outside, they don't get to know you. Mm-hmm. They kind of put you in a kind of bubble.
Okay.
So I feel like it's a black cloud over my head, so I kind of want to clear the air, clear my story, so I can kind of move on in life. So now when people speak to you, they ain't got to wonder, oh, what happened to them? They already seen the story. It's been well documented. But right now, I did take a current job with a new radio station, digital radio station. Mm-hmm. Sports 120, it's the new age, so-called radio, digital, and streaming live on the website. So yeah. I am the NBA analyst for that station. So
okay.
I'm starting to get into the field now about basketball and things like that. But my passion is sports, so I'm definitely going to go back into it. It's just a matter. I'm only 37, so I think I still got time.
Oh,
and I'm inspired now by Jason Kidd, Derek Fisher, and those guys getting, you know, head coaching jobs right fresh out the league and at a very young age. So it's definitely something I'm going to revisit shortly.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I think you're going to be successful in that. I mean, before we close things up, I mean, give everybody all the information they need. Because I personally, just on the outside, not even just because he's a friend and the story, me and Shaq, we support independent films, those kind of things, especially black filmmakers. Yeah. So tell everybody what they need to be doing to support the film and the documentary and get it out there.
Well, first of all, it's called Going the Instant, the Antoine Walker Story. You can follow me on my website, www.antoinewalker8.com, and it keeps up with everything that I'm doing currently in life. Also, the foundation, which I'm starting, I had it for 13 years, so I just changed it over to make it a finance literacy program, so I can be able to try to help some of these young guys, young professional athletes, as well as, you know, just regular people about some financial struggles and share my story with them as well. But the website is what I'm really going through. I'm on Twitter. I'm under my last name, First Walker, mm-hmm. Antoine 8.
Okay.
So those two things, I'm very active in social media now. I'm getting into it and trying to carry my story out there. But the documentary, after we show this private screening, we are going to try to put it out nationwide. So you can just look out for it.
Okay, absolutely. There it is. Antoine Walker inside the Ransford Boost Mobile Lounge. Your boy Togo Poe, man. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thanks for having me.
There it is. Thanks.
Yeah, I'm the only one to get the job done. I don't know and no one that could cover for me. Yeah, got some game from my day. So she might say she love me, she don't love me like she say she love me. Believe me, I'm that nigga boy that love me in the street. I'm not trying to find nobody else to beat. I'm the one they come to see because they are. Believe me, yeah. Rip. It's been me and Young Tune off the rip. That's the man that put me in it. If a nigga f*** with him, I put him down quick. Got a verse for anybody who won't talk about the clip. I've been taking light, you don't wanna hear me trip. God, do y'all really know who y'all f***ing with? Yeah, I mean you can't blame me for wondering. Doesn't matter, could be winter or the summer. On the road, I do One Direction numbers, I don't f***ing miss. Yeah, Stunner and Magno.